Many people have asked, how can we transfer transactions from QuickBooks Desktop to QuickBooks Online? And what they mean is, without overwriting and erasing the QuickBooks Online data. CSV files can add transactions without erasing others. They're really meant to be used for bank feeds and the bank feeds section. They're limited in how much information goes in each transaction. Use these tricks and tips to send as much information as possible in each transaction when transferring from QuickBooks Desktop to QuickBooks Online. Now, I assume you already watched the video on importing CSV files into QuickBooks Online. If not, you can pause this video, watch the other one, and then come back. Here are tricks and tips on how to send transactions from Desktop to QuickBooks Online. Follow these steps exactly, and everything will work fine. First, export transactions from the transaction by account from your trial balance. Well, here we are in the QuickBooks Desktop version. Here's the trial balance. And let's imagine this is the bank account that we want to export from Desktop and then import into QuickBooks Online. To get transaction by account, you should double-click the money amount and you get this report, transaction by account, and it has a list of every transaction that has affected the balance of this particular bank account. Now, this is the only way to export it to Excel without leaving spaces. Other people might have other ideas, like use the advanced find or use the custom report feature, but none of them will get you all the transactions without leaving any spaces. Only by doing it from transaction by account will you have a spreadsheet with no spaces for the transaction list of your bank account. Now, before you export, you should customize the report to show only three columns: date, name, and amount. So let's do that. We go back to the transaction by account that you just double-clicked from the business checking, and we click customize. Now let's remove every check mark except name, date, and amount. Remove this, remove this. Scroll down, careful, scroll down very slowly. Leave date, but remove number and adjustment. Scroll down, leave name, remove memo, remove clear, remove split, remove everything but those three. Now, when it comes to debit, credit, and amount, click to remove the debit, click to remove the credit, and click on amount, and you will see one number amount instead of the debit and credit column. Remove balance. Remove every other column except those three. And then when you click OK, your report should look something like this. Now, export to Excel. OK, Excel, create new workbook. Click export and just wait a moment, and all this data on this report from this bank account, here we go, will be in Excel. Now, save the Excel file as CSV. That's the special format that allows you to import into QuickBooks Online. So we click File, Save As, Desktop, and I guess we could call it Buzz Checking, because that's the name of the bank account, business checking. Click yes. Now, we didn't really save it as CSV. You got to be careful. File, save as. Okay, same place, buzz checking, except we want, in order to save it as CSV, after you put the name, click the type and go up and find CSV, comma separated value. So there's a lot, here it is, comma delimited, this one, CSV. And if you save it in this format, QuickBooks will let you import it into QuickBooks Online. Click Save. and then click OK. Now, change the date format on the top of the date format. Change the date format to the top date format. Now, what do I mean by the top date format? Well, if you right-click on the column heading, you can format the entire column. And when I say the top date format, I mean you come over to this section here in the home ribbon. You have this area called number. Click the corner and click date. So QuickBooks knows this is a date. Now, there are different formats of date, but you should choose the top one. Let's try it again. Date. Make sure the top format on the Excel list, 2 digits for the month, 2 digits for the day, and 4 digits for the year with a forward slash in between, is the format, and that's what you choose. Format the other two columns as general type. Well, that's easy. Right-click on the column heading for name, and then come here and choose general. Okay? Right-click on the column heading for amount, change the type to general. Make sure after the change you click the save button so you don't lose your changes. Now, make sure there are no spaces or uneven rows or columns. Everything has to be smooth or it won't work. Well, what do I mean? Well, look, first of all, let's get rid of this row number 2, right click, delete, so that everything is smooth. Scroll all the way down. If you scroll all the way down, you can see there's a little mess on the bottom. Believe it or not, just having this little mess on the bottom will cause an error message with the wrong error. Take it from someone who has experience. I couldn't believe this was the reason, but you should delete it. In fact, you should clear everything, including the formatting, and then again save the file after the changes. So now everything is nice and smooth, otherwise it won't work. Now, step number 8. Make your column headings exactly this: post date, description, and amount. You have to spell it exactly like this with a space in between and the proper capitalization, which means the capital letter beginning every word. Post date, description, and amount. So first, let's clear everything to make sure it's gone. Then we click here, capital P, post date description. One letter wrong and the whole thing won't work. Description with a capital D, and then amount with a capital A, and then of course save the changes. Now your file is ready to import. And now this is what you do when you're in QuickBooks Online. Match the date and amount to the columns in the Excel QuickBooks Online file. Well, we learned from the previous video to import a CSV file, we click Banking. When you're in your QuickBooks Online account, by the way, you click Banking. Do not click the Update button. You'll be a prisoner for several minutes. Click the pull down arrow and click File Upload, and you get this window, just like we did in the video when we learned how to import CSV files. Click Browse, and I think it was called Business Checking, yes, but Business Checking CSV. Click Open. Now in the bottom right, click Next, and now we have to choose which account in our online QuickBooks account is the business checking account that we are importing the information into. Let's choose business checking, click Next. Now, QuickBooks suggests that column 3 is the date and suggests that this is the format, and in this case it's correct. Now, the column for description is really column 5, okay? Even though we know column 5 is the name, we're telling QuickBooks that column 5 is the description. Well, why are we doing that? We're doing that so that QuickBooks will look at the description column and see the name and execute the rule. And of course, the amount is column 7, the amount field, and then click Next. Now here are all the transactions that we're about to import into QuickBooks Online, going into QuickBooks Online, and these are the money amounts, and they're going into the bank feed center. Now, they will not immediately affect your QuickBooks financial records, except for the ones that follow the rules. So I have already set up rules. If the description column has Mark, it should have a certain income account. If it has Chase, it should have a certain expense account. If it has UPS, and so on. So by setting up the rules, it's the reason. Okay, well, anyway, let's just click Next. Click Yes. Now you'll see the import is complete. Now what does that mean? It means that some of these that did not match a rule are here for your review, and you can review them and add them in a batch or add them one by one. But some of them are all already recorded into QuickBooks. And these three that are already recorded into QuickBooks are recorded there because this is executing a rule. So if you set up rules to look at the description field, and then you use the name as the description field, QuickBooks will see the name, and it will automatically put what you want as the name and as the account, because it's executing the rules that you set up before. And that's how you do it.